Now let's learn example number 6. The earnings of A, B and C are in the ratio 4:5:6. If A earns rupees 64 per day, how much do B and C earn? See, in the question, only the earnings of A per day is given. That is, A earns 64 rupees per day. And we don't know for B and C earning, but we only know the ratio, that is 4:5:6 is only given. So in the question they are asking how much do B and C earn. We do not know. See, only for A is given, but for B and C is not given in the question. How we can find out? Let's say, let the earnings of A, B and C in a day be equal to x. Okay, let the earnings of A, B and C per day be equal to your x. Okay, now we have the ratio, that is for A's to B's to C ratio is 4:5:6. Now we do not have the total value also. Previously in some sums what we have done, we have added all this only when we have something in total it's given, but there is no total amount of money is given. So in this case we are not going to do that way. Okay, so we will do that. It is 4. Now what is the earning of, say the earning of AB, suppose A earns rupees 4 into x, okay, per day. Now similarly we can write B earns how much? Rupees ratio is 5x per day, and your C earns equal to rupees 6x per day. Now in this case what we will do is we will equate, because only A earns 64 per day it's given. So we have assumed that A earns 4x per day. That is, A's earn 4x per day. It's equal to, what is the total amount given? It is rupees 64. And this side also rupees. So I need to find the value of x. Then only I can find B and C value. Okay. Now x will be equal to, see, this rupees will get cancelled. So this will get cancelled. So we will write 64 by 4. Okay, x is equal to 64 by 4. Now we can have 4 ones are 4. You can divide in your own way. Okay, so it is 16. We will get 16. X value is 16. So x value is 16. That is, now we can find out automatically. Now we can find out for B earnings and C earnings. So we have already got the value of x. So your B earns will be rupees how much? 5 into x value is 16. So how much? 80. Rupees 80 per day. And your C will earn rupees, it is 6x. So 6 into your x value is 16. So how much? 16 into 6, 96 per day. Okay, we will find this way. We will assume first, because we have to find the value of x in this case. Then only we will be able to find the value of B and C earnings. Now this is example number 7 of your textbook. That is, if A is to B is equal to 7:9, and B is to C is equal to 3 is to 2. Find A is to C. Okay, we have to find the ratio A is to C. How are we going to find out? So, many of you will be writing. You all may think that A is to C. Now, what is the value of A? Your A is 7. And what is your C? See, C is 2. This is wrong. Okay, you should not do this way. How we are going to do is, we have to find A by C. That means we have to use this ratio to find the value of A by C. How? You see here, A by B. That is, A is to B. I can write as A by B. Into, next is B is to C. B is to C. This is the correct way of finding. Now we know. You see here? Now we know. Don't cancel this B and B, because both the values of B are different here. B is 9 and B is 3. So, what is your A? Your A is 7. And what is your B? Your B is 9. And what is the ratio of B is to C? B is 3. There are two values here. This is not a continued proportion. And this is 2. Okay. Now, 3 we can divide. 3 ones are 3 and 3 threes are 9. So, it is 7 by 6. See, this is the correct answer. Not this. Remember this.